What's happening, people? Before we get started, I just want to say thanks to everybody who's subscribed to me so far. It means a lot. If you haven't subscribed and you've been liking my videos, what I've been doing, then please subscribe to me. It would mean a lot to me and it would help me. On this video, it's being requested for me to do an Alex K. Dinky style. What I've done, I've copied Alex K. Gotta Be Love, the riff pattern on that. This is what the melody sounds like with the sample I have made for it. So let's hear it. Now, obviously, it doesn't sound exactly the same as Alex K because he's used a different synth more than likely. Well, I know for a fact he definitely did because this weren't around back then. It was more than likely a sample or a hardware synth what he had. I know the Club Heads, they were the first to use this type of sample, I think. They definitely used an external hardware synth. I'm not sure what it is. I'm not sure whether it was one of the Junos or something like that. But they nailed that sound. And Alex K obviously jumped on board with it. That synth was from Alex K, Gotta Be Love. And I'm going to attempt to make that again right now for you. And try and get it to exactly the same as that, I suppose. So let's take it off a track and start from the beginning. So the first thing I do is add 16 voices of unison and detune it a little bit to about 27. Let's hear it. Then I add the filter and bring the cutoff all the way up. Add some drive to beefing it up a bit. Bring the fatness up a little bit. Bring the resonance all the way down. Now there's where the magic is. Because it's a plucky sound, you want to have it right down to make it into a pluck. Let's hear that. Now with the envelope too as well, you can assign it to the cutoff if you want to filter it a little bit more. And you want to bring this one right down too, to make it even more pluckier. Let's hear it. It's close already. Add a little bit of release time. Add a little bit of release time on the envelope one. So let's hear that with the pattern I've got now. As you can hear, that's already close. Let's turn it down a bit on the master. It's pretty straightforward, this. I don't know why people haven't jumped on it already, to be fair. It's really easy. Bring the run down a little bit so it's not random as much. Now, the key is all in the effects as well, I think, with this sound. So let's add an EQ. Let's turn the low pass down a little bit and the high pass up. Let's hear it. It's already sort of close to what I had last time. Then when you add reverb to that, it brings it to life, I think. So let's bring it down a bit on the size. Pre-delay none. Bring the low cut up a bit. Higher the high cut a little bit. Bring the dampness down a touch. Now this should sound a lot better now, let's hear it. We're getting there. Let's add a delay now. Let's see what we can do here. Let's bring it down a touch. Have it on ping pong. Have the left channel going to 1/8 and the right to 1/4, which is a quarter. Bring that down a bit. Let's hear that. I mean, that sounds pretty good to me already. What else you could do with it is probably add a compressor on it as well to beefen it up a bit. So bring the threshold down a touch, add the gain, ratio 2:1, bring the attack down a touch, let's hear it. That's really close. But the best thing to make it better, I think, is to add external effects. So I add another EQ on the channel, and then obviously I have mine going to a bus. So this is what it sounds like with all my effects on. It just makes it sound that bit better. So, you don't have to do that yourself. I mean, you can add your own effects in and stuff like that. I just want to see how loud that is, actually. That sounds well better. Now, I've chopped Alex K's tune up here to see if it does sound good and if it does sound like his dinky. So, hopefully I've got it to the way I had it before. And let's hear it on here. I think I've done a pretty good job there to recreate what I made. It sounds as close as what you're going to get to Alice K's Dinky, really, on that song. I mean, I think I've done an all right job there, really. So, yeah, that's how you make Alice K's Dinky sample. I mean, you can use the samples, what everyone is using, but I think... why not just recreate it and get it a perfectly sounding synth instead of like an old recorded sample, what's been doing the rounds for years? Why don't you just make it? And you've got all you need to do then is just press that to save it. And then I've already got mine saved there. And that's yours forever. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you've learned something. And I'll see you on my next video.